Hello everyone, welcome to Crossover Worship. We're so glad that you can join us for worship online today. And before we begin, can we just take time to ready our hearts, take time to humble our hearts before God? And as we pray and as we reflect, let's welcome God's presence to wherever we are today, wherever we're worshiping. Let's take time to thank God. Let's say, Lord, I'm here to worship you today. Lord, come alive in our presence. Lord, touch my heart. Work through me. Transform me. Say, God, I want to meet you. I desire to build a deeper relationship with you through this worship. Will you bow our heads and let's pray together. Let's take a short moment to reflect and then we'll begin together. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for gathering us here today. From wherever we are, Lord, we just want to thank you that we have been given this opportunity to worship. We're glad that we can worship freely from wherever we are, Lord. God, in the midst of this corona outbreak, Lord, in the midst of fear and anxiety filling the hearts of just many people around the world, God, I pray that this time of worship will be a time where we can look towards hope. I pray that time of worship will be a chance for us to look towards you, a chance for us to find peace in you, Lord. Father God, we just want to also thank you, Lord, and acknowledge that we're not worshiping because we have to. We're not worshiping for any other reason except for the very reason. We worship you because you called us first into your presence. You call each and every one of us by name today. And Lord, you desire to grow deeper in relationship with us. Lord, through this worship, transform us, mold our hearts. Father God, break our heart for what breaks yours. And Lord, renew our hearts. Fill it anew with your love and your grace. Father God, we thank you, we love you, and we pray all these things in your name. Amen. Amen. All right, let's praise together.
In your presence, all our fears are washed away. Oh, when we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away. Washed away. Hosanna, Hosanna. You are the God who saves us, worthy of all our praises. Hosanna, Hosanna. Come have your way among us. We welcome you here, Lord Jesus. Hosanna.
Far be it from me to not believe, even when my eyes can't see, and this mountain that's in front of me will be thrown into the midst of the sea. And through it all,
it is well every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you. Every breath we could ever breathe, we live for you.
Hello, welcome to Crossover Worship. We're glad that you can join us for worship online today. Here are the announcements. Sunday offering can be given today and throughout the week. Wire transfer information is below. And please remember to note your name in the memo. Crossover holds English worship every Sunday at 12:30 p.m. We gather at 예수마을교회, Jesustown Ministry in Band Hall. All families and all ages from young and old are welcome to our community. For more information, you can email or contact us. Follow us on social media for more information on our ministry. Don't forget to like, follow, and subscribe. You can find our full worship content on YouTube, and sermons are also uploaded weekly onto our YouTube channel. Due to the coronavirus outbreak, we are not gathering at church. We have temporarily been live on YouTube for online worship. Online worship will continue until further notice. You can worship with us live on our YouTube channel on Sunday at 12:30 p.m. Hello, everyone. Welcome to Crossover Worship. I'm so glad that you can join us for worship online today. Before we go into God's Word, can we have a time of prayer? Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for gathering us here today. And Lord, as we listen to your Word, open our eyes, open our ears, and open our hearts. God, we want to see a glimpse of your glory. Lord, we want to hear your voice speaking to us. And deep down in the depths of our hearts, Lord, we want to feel the conviction of your word piercing through our hearts. But also, Lord, we want to feel your word. We want to feel your truth, your love, your grace, and your mercy deep down in the depths of our hearts, Lord. Father God, touch our hearts, transform our hearts. Lord, we thank you, we love you, and we pray all these things in your name. Amen. Amen. Today's sermon title is Stay on Your Toes. Again, it's Stay on Your Toes. And today's word comes from Matthew chapter 8, verse 23 to 27. Again, today's word comes from Matthew chapter 8, verse 23 to 27. It says, "Then he got into the boat, and his disciples followed him. Suddenly, a furious storm came up on the lake, so that the waves swept over the boat. But Jesus was sleeping. The disciples went and woke him, saying, 'Lord, save us, we're going to drown.' He replied, 'You of little faith, why are you so afraid?' Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the waves, and it was completely calm. The men were amazed and asked, 'What kind of man is this? Even the winds and the waves obey him.'" Amen. Amen. Word of God for the people of God. Amen. Currently, all around the world, coronavirus, as you all may probably know, coronavirus has been spreading, and it's actually spread to pretty much many parts of the entire world now. It's been spreading and bringing much fear into people's lives. This fear makes people panic. Many people have been anxious. A lot of anxiety has been being raised in many countries. And it seems as though the chaos is increasing more and more. Also, just a couple days ago, the World Health Organization officially declared the virus to be a global pandemic. Of course, this makes people freak out even more. It raises the anxiety level even more. It makes people scared even more. Not only does a global pandemic spark fear, but it seems that even the little things in life can spark fear into our lives. We fear about becoming broke, about running out of money. We fear about time running out as the clock keeps ticking every second. We fear death. Some people, we fear new transitions. Maybe some people fear being lost or even being a loser in society. And the very sad thing is that this generation relies on drugs more than any other generation in history. Children today are more fearful and have anxiety even more than any patient in history. People even say today that a much greater virus than the coronavirus itself is fear, is anxiety. Also, this anxiety is a much more dangerous virus that people can catch on to. It's much more dangerous than corona itself. And however, this fear, technically, thinking about fear isn't technically something that's bad. Fear is only bad if you let it take over your heart and you lose control over your life. Again, fear is not something bad. Fear is only bad if you let it take over your life and control your life. However, today I want to share with you that there is a good side to fear. There's a healthier way to respond to fear. We see this response in scripture today, and that is to stay on your toes. Again, stay on your toes. Be ready to take action. And just like today's sermon title, stay on your toes. Fear may seem like it defeats us and makes us want to hide and give up and run away and to be scared. However, in times of fear, let faith enable you to stay on your toes. And there are three ways on how our faith enables us to stay on our toes. Again, three ways how faith enables us to be ready to take action. The first thing is, faith enables us to respond in sudden situations. Secondly, faith enables us to realize our true reality. And lastly, third, faith enables us to remember that Christ is in control. Today we see in our passage, Jesus has been ministering to many people, performing miracles and sharing God's word with many crowd members. He's healed a man with leprosy. He's healed the centurion's servant. He's healed many who were ill and also demon-possessed. And Jesus finished his sermon near the area of Galilee and returned back to Capernaum, got on a boat with his disciples, and they went to cross the Sea of Galilee. Jesus and his disciples got on a boat together, and in verse 24 it says, "Suddenly a furious storm came up, and the waves swept over the boat." Now, how big was this storm? The Greek word used for this furious storm, or a great storm, it's expressed as a great seismos. And a great seismos, right? Kind of like seismic activity. It's like a great quake, a great shaking between the sea and the sky. The sea was shaking, the sky was shaking. How did this happen? Again, it said it happened suddenly, out of nowhere. The Sea of Galilee, you see, it's a small body of water. However, even though it's a small body of water, sudden storms around the Sea of Galilee can create very violent waves, and it can be very dangerous. Now, Scripture didn't say that Jesus got on the boat and they enjoyed the sunset and the disciples were happy that they were with Jesus. That would have been nice. But again, a sudden storm took over. Now, obviously, this event stirred sudden fear. If I was on that boat, I'd be freaking out. And the next thing is that I would immediately think about the worst case scenario, which is death. I would probably die out here in the waters during the storm. Now, while all this is happening, Jesus is asleep on the boat. Now, would you look at that? Think about it for a sec. There's a big storm raging. Suddenly, a storm comes in. And it says that Jesus is sleeping on the boat. There's a storm. People are about to die. The waves are crashing into the boat. It's kind of weird that Jesus is asleep. But realize that the disciples didn't just freak out. They weren't just scared. They immediately shouted. Let's look at verse 25. They immediately shouted, "Lord, save us! We're going to drown." Again, "Lord, save us, we're going to drown." Now, in the Greek translation, there's literally three words that they were shouting out. You can put it simply as, "Lord, save, dying." Again, "Lord, save us, we're dying." What we see here is the disciples responding in faith during the sudden situation in the waters. And that's the first thing I want to share with you today. Is that faith enables us to respond in sudden situations. We know that the disciples' faith is responding in this very situation because they shout, "Lord," they shout, they call upon the name of the Lord. They shout, "Lord." They look towards Christ for help. We see the disciples sharing their faith in Christ right before they actually get on this boat. Now, we didn't read the passage, but if we look at a couple verses before what we read today, in Matthew chapter 8, verse 18 to 22, Matthew shares and talks about the cost of following Jesus. The disciples hear Jesus sharing about how it takes sacrifice to follow him, trusting Jesus on the journey that they will go on with him. Now, right after hearing Jesus speak about what it takes to become his disciples, about the faith that is required to follow him, to surrender all and follow him, it's as if the disciples were put to the test right away. Who else would the disciples look for when they're scared? Who else would the disciples look for when they're in a challenging situation? Or when they're facing a sudden storm such as this? It's Jesus. Again, faith enables the disciples to respond in this sudden situation by calling out to Jesus, by calling out, "Lord, save us, we're dying." Just like how a little baby cries for its mom when something seems wrong. When mom suddenly disappears for a second and the baby feels anxious. Or when the baby is hurt or sick. Or when a baby just wants attention. A baby cries knowing and trusting that its mom will come over to comfort it. Again, just like a baby crying for its mother, knowing and trusting, having faith in its mother coming to make things better. The mother would come and go, shh, it's okay, my child. It'll all be okay. The first name, just like a baby crying out for its mom, the first name that the disciples shouted out was Lord. Although they were overcome with fear, their faith and trust in Jesus enabled them to respond by shouting for Jesus in this sudden situation. And I want to ask you all the same. When we face a sudden storm in our life, when we face a sudden shaking in our life, when we feel shaken up suddenly, how do you respond? Whose name do you call upon when there is sudden chaos in your life? And I pray that the very name that you cry out is the name of Jesus. I pray that we are people of faith who cry out, Lord, searching for Christ first in the sudden chaos. Place your faith in Him and trusting that He will come and protect you. However, if we look deep into our faith and see what's really happening around us when sudden storms shake us up, fear pretty much destroys our confidence in God's goodness. We question whether God actually cares about us or if He doesn't care about us. And the same passage we read today, it's also mentioned in the Gospel of Mark. The same narrative told in the point of perspective of Mark. In Mark chapter 4, verse 38, here's what it says. It says, Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. The disciple woke Him and said to Him, Teacher, don't you care if we drown? Again, teacher, don't you care if we drown? Now what happens here is, yes, the disciples have faith in Christ. They call out for Jesus. They know that Jesus is the person to place their faith in, to trust during this sudden, scary storm that's happening. However, the disciples realize their reality. It's that their faith helps them realize their true reality. And that's the second thing I want to share with you. The second thing is that faith enables us to realize our reality. The reality for the disciples was, their reality was that, oh no, we're about to die. The storm's really dangerous. The boat's about to sink. And Jesus is busy sleeping. That's the reality right now. How can Jesus sleep? Now, if I was a disciple, I would honestly, my reality wouldn't be, oh, okay, let's let Jesus sleep. And He's very tired from ministry. No, right now, Jesus is asleep. And right now, I'm about to die. How could He be asleep? For reals? Sleeping? If Jesus' eyes were shut, then I would also think, maybe He doesn't really care about me. Maybe I'll just wind up dying in this storm. Does He actually care? You know, this fear starts to turn into doubt. And the doubt makes us angry against Jesus. And we start taking control because we're scared. We can't wait anymore. And when we try to take control, everything actually winds up getting out of control in our lives. Again, when we try to take control, everything actually goes out of control and becomes even more chaotic in our life. Fear ultimately results in losing control over my life. Think of it this way. It's as if, say you're drowning in the water and the lifeguard comes to save you and you refuse to let the lifeguard help you because you're panicking in the water right now. You're scared that you might die. The water is scaring you and you want to try and swim as hard as you can. And you're swimming and swimming and swimming. You're trying to tread in the water, trying to keep yourself floating in the water. The lifeguard is trying to help you, but you're making it even harder for the lifeguard to help you because you lose control over your breathing. You lose control over the entire situation. You can't stay calm. The lifeguard is having a hard time trying to save you, trying to keep things calm for you. And all you can think about is the worst case scenario, which is drowning in the water. And now what you feel, you feel cornered, the worst case scenario, you're trapped, you're in a dead end. And in the same way, the disciples feel like they're pinned to the corner of a wall. There's a dead end. There's nowhere else to go now. And Jesus is sleeping. But that doesn't mean that He doesn't care that they're going through a challenging time. The disciples, they're losing control. They're scared. It's as if they've forgotten the very goodness of Jesus Christ. Again, the disciples are losing control. They're scared. And it's as if they've forgotten the very goodness of Jesus. The very goodness of knowing Jesus who cares for them, who loves for them. The very Jesus who has been ministering with them. The disciples, they've just witnessed. They were a part of Jesus' great ministry. Ministering to people, feeding people, performing miracles, casting out demons, healing the sick. Showing love to the poor. But they've forgotten the goodness of Christ. They've forgotten the goodness of trusting in Christ. The goodness of having faith in Christ and His beloved disciples. But the reality for them, as mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew, is that the disciples were crying out, "Save us! We're dying, Lord!" By faith, the disciples are acknowledging, pretty much, "Lord, we're nothing without you." Again, by faith, the disciples are acknowledging that they are nothing without Christ. They are acknowledging their reality of the fear that's present before them right now. It is a reality where fear makes them lose control. A reality where their own safety and comfort becomes greater than God's goodness. A reality where I can't trust Jesus and I'd rather do it all on my own. However, by faith, the disciples are able to cry out to Christ because they know the true reality of being Christ's disciples. They know the true reality is giving Christ full control over my life, trusting Christ, knowing that being Christ's disciple is a risk worth taking. We realize, and the disciples are realizing, the goodness of Christ in their life. You see, if we look at the bigger picture, fear isn't just, it's not just an unhealthy response to sudden situations and chaos in our life. Now, yes, of course, fear itself, it's technically not a sin. But yes, it can lead to sin in our lives. Sins such as excluding God from the solution and making the problem even greater. Excluding God and making myself God, trying to take control over my life. Or we allow anxiety to take over and define our lives. But today, I want to remind us all that although fear may be filling the world right now, even in a time such as this with the virus outbreak, fear may be filling the entire world, but fear does not have to fill our hearts. Again, I want to remind us all that even though fear is filling the world right now, fear does not have to fill our hearts. Fear actually serves as a healthy function in our lives, believe it or not. Again, fear serves as a healthy function in our lives. For example, being able to call out to Christ for help, realizing the true reality and goodness of life with Christ during these times of fears. Or also coming to realize that Christ is in full control during these times of fear. And lastly, knowing that Christ has full authority, has full control over the situations. And that's the last thing I want to share with you. The third and last thing is that faith enables us to remember that Christ is in control. Amen. Our passage ends today with verse 26 to 27. It says, "He replied, 'You of little faith, why are you so afraid?' Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the waves, and it was completely calm." Verse 27, "The men were amazed and asked, 'What kind of man is this? Even the winds and the waves obey him.'" Now what happens here is Jesus rebukes his disciples, not because they had no faith. Again, Jesus says, "You of little faith, why are you so afraid?" Again, Jesus rebukes his disciples not because they had no faith at all. Again, it's not because they had absolutely no faith, but it's because their faith was weak. Their faith wasn't enough at that time. Right after rebuking the disciples, Jesus gets up and he calms the storm. He calms the waves, the winds die down, and the disciples, they're amazed. They ask, "Who is this man? Who is this Jesus? Even the winds and waves obey him." The disciples' faith enabled them to witness enable them to be able to believe in the full power and authority of Jesus Christ. Christ not only calmed down the sea, but he also calmed down the disciples' fears. This question, who is this man? Who is this Jesus? And I want to share with you all today that this very man, this Jesus, this man is Jesus Christ, who is fully human, who is fully divine. He is the Son of God, God who is our Creator, our Heavenly Father, who created everything in this world for us because he loves you and I so much. He loves his people so much. He loved them so much that he sent his one and only Son to die for us. God, who is sovereign over all, who has full authority and control over creation. He also loves his people so much. Again, he loves them so much. He loves them so much that on the day that he sent his Son died on the day that Jesus Christ died on the cross, people were watching him. And even then they were asking, who is this man? Even when Jesus was ministering to people, when people were hearing about the Son of Man, the Messiah walking around and ministering, people were around the neighborhood were asking, who is this Jesus? Who is this man? And he is the Christ who came to bring peace, to bring shalom into the kingdom of God, to calm the fear of God's people, and to bring peace on earth. Amen. You know, what makes us Christ's disciples is not about the absence of storms in life. Take it this way. If we are disciples of Christ, that doesn't mean that all the storms in our lives will disappear. If we are disciples in Christ, it doesn't mean that there won't be any storms at all. It's not about, oh, I believe in God, and so the storms, they'll disappear forever. But living our faith out is about who we discover in the storm. Again, living our faith out is not about the storms disappearing forever, but living our faith out is about who we discover in the storm. And that is Jesus Christ. Amen. Brothers and sisters, I want to challenge you this week. I know as the coronavirus, as the outbreak is spreading more and more around the world, can we take this week? I want to challenge you all to think about this fear and in another angle, in another perspective. Think about how does our faith play into such a time as this? Our faith is enabling us, is challenging us. We are challenged to remember that Christ is in control. We're challenged to remember that it is Jesus who cares for us. It is Jesus who is there for us every step of the way. Brothers and sisters, again, our faith is about who we discover in that storm. And it is Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Will you join me in prayer? And today, as we pray and reflect, I want to ask you all, where are you in your faith? Again, where are you in your faith? Maybe you're facing a lot of anxiety right now. Or maybe you're trying to take control over your life. Or maybe you've lost control of your life. Maybe you've forgotten the very goodness of God in your life. Or your heart is filled with such fear that you're just, that everything is just chaotic in your life. At this time, can we reflect, where is our faith right now? And can we, and as we reflect, can we pray to God and say, Lord, help my faith grow? Can we cry out, Lord, help me? Lord, save me. Christ, save me. Can we tell God, Lord, my reality is that you are a good God. Even during this time of fear, you are a good, good God. And can we also ask Christ to be in control? Christ, rule over my life. Christ, take full control of my life. And also, can we just pray for our brothers and sisters around the world who may be stuck in this fear, who may be stuck in anxiety right now as they're dealing with, as they're facing a challenging time with the virus outbreak. Will you join me in prayer? Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for gathering us here today. Heavenly Father, we acknowledge and we confess at this time that we're so anxious. We're scared. Our hearts are filled with fear at such a time like this. Lord, help our faith to grow. Lord, we cry out to you, Lord, Lord, save us. We're dying, we're scared, we're anxious, Lord. Lord, help your people. And Lord, have mercy on all those around the world at this time. Lord, remind us that the very reality is that the goodness of Christ is there. Help us to remember the very goodness of Christ. Christ who loves us, Christ who cares for us, Christ who protects us every second of our lives, Lord. Lord, help us to remember, Lord, that many times, even during the times where we want to take full control, Lord, help us to remember that Christ is the full authoritator. Christ is sovereign over all. Help us to remember that you rule, that you have full control over all of creation. Lord, we just want to lift up to you our brothers and sisters all around the world. For those who have been affected, Lord, as the coronavirus outbreak has been rising, Lord, and in many other countries, Lord. Lord, we pray for their safety. We pray for their health. Lord, we pray that the very fear and anxiety that clouds over them, Lord, Lord, help them to look towards hope. Help them to look towards your very love. Lord, protect them, guide them, and we pray that your peace will be with just all the families, Lord, who may be affected right now. Lord God, we pray that as we go from this place, wherever we go, Lord, wherever we are, whatever we do this week, may every action that we take, Lord, every action that we do, Lord, may it be an act of worship unto you. Father God, we love you, we thank you, we pray all these things in your name. Amen. Amen. Well, guys, thank you everyone for joining us again for worship. And just once again, as this virus outbreak continues to spread even more around the world, we just want to keep in mind that this is the time to be praying. This is the time to keep in mind our brothers and sisters just all across the world. Again, don't let this fear and anxiety fill your hearts, but let this time be a time where we can place our faith in Christ alone. Where we can help others realize that when we place our faith in Christ, that when we place our Christ in our sovereign God, that there is nothing more to fear. Again, I just wanted to remind you, as I did during the sermon, that the storms don't disappear in our life. But living out our faith, it's about looking towards and discovering Jesus Christ in that storm. You guys, we love you so much, and may God bless you. And I pray that everyone will be safe this week. All right, see you guys.